Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to all of you joining us today. My name is Nabil. I'm very happy to be joining you all for this log file integration webinar. I see, as always, a few familiar names in the attendees list. Great to see you guys join us. A few new names, but still a few names that I recognize nonetheless. So thanks so much for joining us today and taking roughly an hour of your time for this webinar. I hope not to take the entire hour, but you know, if so, we will make sure not to go over. So what will we cover today? As always, I've split this webinar into four different sections. First, we'll take a look at the integration itself. I want to spend a bit more time than usual here just to clear out any confusion that we might have with the log file integration. Then we'll take a look at how we can set up a crawl, followed by seeing what new reports the integration has produced, as well as finally looking at what these new reports, how these new reports can be used with specific use cases. So let's start off with the integration itself. And with regards to the integration itself, what it is not more specifically, this integration is not, so the log file integration is not an analyzer, right? DeepCrawl has not transformed itself into a log file analyzer. I know many other solutions such similar to DeepCrawl have decided to go into the log file analysis route. We made the decision not to follow that route. The very reason we've decided not to become an analyzer is because there's absolutely no overlap between crawling and analyzing logs. So crawling a website requires very different skills, very different development skills than log file analysis. And as a result, we decided instead to allow you to pick your log file analyzer of choice. Now, you can see three names over here. Many of you, and I'll go into this in a bit more detail afterwards, many of you have already used some of these. But depending on the size of your website, you're going to want to use basically one of these sites. Splunk is probably the better known provider up here. Splunk provides log file analysis for bigger sites, big sites. And I know a few of you, at least some of the accounts that I've spoken to before, use Splunk. Then you have the other end of the spectrum, which is small sites that can take advantage of running the analysis locally on their computer. And their Screaming Frog is where it becomes really valuable to take advantage of that solution. It's $99 a year to use Screaming Frog's log file analyzer. And if your machine can deal with it, then that's great. And for the sites in between, we've got Logzio. Logzio is a great provider for log file analysis. And should your site be a little bigger than your computer can handle, Logzio will be able to do the trick. So what is it? So we figured what it is not, but what is it? So the log file integration acts as an additional source. An additional source in the existing four or five that we already have. These are, as you know, Google Analytics, Search Console, as we covered last month, Majestic and Ahref data for backlinks, and then, of course, your website and sitemap crawl. For those of you who are interested in knowing a bit more about backlinks, improve the backlink integration at the same time as last week's log file release. So now you don't have to convert your data into DeepCrawl friendly. You can just drag and drop it from Majestic and Ahref. We'll be covering all of this and more in next month's webinar, but that's something you can take into consideration today. If you'd like to know more about what we call the search universe, which is basically taking into account all these different sources, and providing a full understanding, a full technical understanding of your website, I recommend taking a look at John Myers. So DeepCrawl's John Myers did a session at Brighton SEO on the main stage last Friday. We will share the link with you in the chat section right now, but you can also always find all of these resources from our website by searching the keywords that appear in the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. If you'd like to take a look and sort of refresh your memory and take a look at the webinar that we that I conducted last month, as well as try to get a better understanding of what the Search Console integration is. We're also sharing the link to that right now in the chat box, and you can, as always, find it through the DeepCrawl search bar. Now, let's go back and take a further look at what the integration is, right? We've defined what it is and what it isn't, but what will it produce? It'll give you an understanding of, you know, how often Googlebot is hitting your pages, and how often Googlebot is hitting me pages. Sorry, I didn't mean to sound Irish there, but I guess it's coming off as a bit Irish. Which pages is Googlebot avoiding, maybe? How are there any orphan pages? This is something I'll cover a little bit more afterwards. Any orphan pages that Googlebot is creating? Is Google accessing my site using MobileBot or its desktop bot? So, and also understanding how frequently Googlebot is accessing certain pages, whether they be indexable, non-indexable, in your sitemap, or in your website as well. We'll take a look at all these things as well. So let's take a quick snapshot at what the new reports look like. I'll go a bit more in depth afterwards as to how you can use these reports in the use cases section. But some of these reports are pages with no bot hits, pages with low bot hits, error pages with bot hits. So these are 400 errors, 500 errors, so server errors that have Googlebot activity on them, or any bot, search engine activity on them. Non-indexable pages with bot hits. Pages without hits in sitemaps. I'll get into a bit more detail as to how these might be avoided in the future. And then finally, disallowed pages with bot hits. As many of you might think, Google will not access your disallowed pages, but in some cases they will. In fact, they might even index these pages. They just won't have any title or descriptions on them. So it's worth taking a look at these pages and understanding why these disallowed pages are still getting bot hits. Some of the graphs that we've produced, you can see them here in the log file overview. It's hosted here. I'm just highlighting it now with that blue box. In the left-hand nav under log files, you can see the overview, which shows you every reports we have. And then you can click, obviously, into each one individually to take a look at them. So let's go back, take another step back. Now, we asked you all several weeks ago which log file analyzer you use. In fact, we were actually quite surprised to see that roughly 65 to 70% of you already use a log file analyzer. Roughly only 30% don't currently have a log file analyzer. But we were happily surprised to see that most of you use Screaming Frog's log file analyzer for those smaller sites or for those smaller crawls. If, for example, you're dealing with maybe a smaller project where you don't need to look at all your logs. So as a result, what I'd like to do is show you how to set up a crawl using Screaming Frog as the log file analyzer. So what I'm going to do over here is I'm quickly going to put this away. I'm going to put this away as well. And you can see I've got the log file analyzer. This is the free version of Screaming Frog's log file analyzer. And I'm going to create a new project. I'm going to drag and drop. I wonder if I can do this quite simply like this. No. So what I'm going to do is create a new project. So bear in mind, you can always use Screaming Frog's free version for up to 500 pages. I'm going to call this DeepCrawl's logs. These are actually DeepCrawl's logs that you'll see over here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag the raw logs up over here. I'm going to type https://deepcrawl.com. And then the analysis is going to run. Now, of course, it's a free trial, so it's going to be very, very limited. And I haven't put that many raw lines in there just for the benefit of this demo. What I'll then do is go to URLs, hit export. URL, I'll put it in the desktop as well. And now I'm going to open up DeepCrawl. So I'm going to create a new project. Now, of course, you can always integrate these logs into an existing crawl. Now, DeepCrawl, as you can imagine, we know how to block crawlers. and anyone from crawling our site. So what we've done, you can see an NA response. Now, it's not to say that you can't keep going. Maybe you need to whitelist, as many of you might have clients where you just need to simply whitelist DeepCrawl's Googlebot. What I'll do is I'll select HTTPS with www, which is what I know the configuration to be, and you can see automatically I can save and continue. So now, for the purpose of this crawl, I'm going to really integrate as many sources as possible, but what I'll do is I'll just quickly go through the ones that don't, that you know, which aren't really the focus of today's session. So obviously I want to get Search Console data to get, you know, an idea of what pages are indexable and which pages are not. Analytics data to get a complete understanding of the organic traffic that I'm getting from my site, not just Google's traffic. Backlink data, so integrating, and again, this is the concept of the search universe. Really take advantage of as many sources as you can possibly integrate here. So backlink data, as I said, I can drag and drop. This is a new improvement that we've done to backlinks. Drag and drop data from Majestic. And then finally, log summary. What I can do is I can quickly drag and drop the data that I just converted, right, that Screaming Frog just analyzed and summarized for me and upload it to DeepCrawl. And you can see it processing over here. Now, it means it can take a few seconds. You can upload a file up to 100 megabytes. Now, I highly doubt that a log file summary will go above 100 megabytes. If it does, you can always split it into different files, and you can add them each 100 megabyte CSV one at a time, drag and drop them, each of them here. Now we can keep going. As the data is being processed into DeepCrawl, you can save and continue, and then proceed through the four steps of DeepCrawl, which I'm not going to do here for the benefit of saving time. But this is essentially how you would set up a crawl. It's very straightforward. You can see that as soon as you have the raw data analyzed, and in some cases, if you're using Splunk or Logsio, when you're dealing with larger sites, it might take a little longer, but then it's just a matter of dragging and dropping that into DeepCrawl, and you can see that the data has already been processed. And you can see that, I should actually make a note of this, we've identified the data to be Screaming Frog log files. And it's important for us to stress this, because many of you might think that we can't support every log file analyzer. Yes, we can. And if you notice that there's one, you know, maybe there's a one that you're running internally within your company, you can always tell us about it. Email support@deepcrawl.com, and we'll be sure to support it in the next release. Now let's go back to the presentation. What are these use cases? I've just shown you how to set up a crawl. Now, once the crawl is finalized, once it's identified all these pages, what can I actually do with it? So one of the main benefits, and this won't be a surprise to many of you, it's to identify pages with no bot traffic on them, right? You can see from this graph that we've, you know, shown you in a very visual manner. What is the proportion? What is the breakdown of these pages? There's very few pages that have low bot traffic or none whatsoever. You can see that only 14% of pages have no bot traffic. Now, bear in mind, this is a dummy report, but it can still show you quite visually, show you quite visually what's wrong with that crawl. It can also show you if you've got any non-indexable pages that are maybe wasting your crawl budget. Now, this is something that you'll want to take into consideration, just because, non-indexable pages with bot hits on them, that's a waste of crawl budget. One of the things you might want to do is maybe change your mind. Maybe these are canonicalized pages that actually Google's decided to index. And so you can actually use the data from Search Console, from the Search Console integration, to validate whether or not these pages are driving impressions. And so what you can actually do is use the filters over here. Use the filter, put found in Search Console as well, or have a certain amount of impressions, and we will be able to show you which of these non-indexable pages with bot hits are actually indexed as well. One of the things that you might actually want to do based on these pages is also maybe consider changing your sitemap. I'll get to that in just a moment. But the next use case is discovering which bot is accessing your pages. This will become increasingly important with the release of mobile-first indexing in the next year. Google will start crawling your site and crawling your pages with both the regular Googlebot as well as Googlebot's smartphone. In fact, you can use DeepCrawl to crawl both to crawl your site using both smartphone and the generic Googlebot. But the reason why this is important, and it doesn't just apply to m.dot pages, to mobile alternate pages, but it's also quite valuable for sites that are configured using responsive as well as dynamic configurations. So for responsive, for example, what Google's going to do with mobile first is crawl your pages using a Googlebot smartphone or a mobile bot, and then it's going to make sure and validate the content on with the response from the regular Googlebot response. So it's going to take a look. It's going to crawl your site basically the same URL twice, not at the same time, but it's going to crawl your URL A, let's call it, with Googlebot first. It's going to understand the title, the description, the content really on that page, and then it's going to run the crawl again maybe a few days later with Googlebot smartphone to see whether the content is the same, whether the title is the same, whether the body content has changed in any way. And if it has, then that will be an issue. So this is one of the reasons why we'll show you here the breakdown between the different bots that Google's going to use. So I've addressed responsive. There are going to be some changes also to dynamic pages. So search engines need to be able to crawl both user agents to validate the response. The way you can understand whether a page is dynamic is based on the vary rule in the header. It's going to say vary user agent, and as a result, that's going to trigger Google to come back using the mobile bot. And then obviously for your mobile alternate, search engines will need to crawl the dedicated mobile URLs with the mobile user agent to validate the pages, and obviously to confirm that the content matches with the desktop pages. Another use case that you can take is taking advantage of the high bot hits. So take advantage of these pages, to spread bot activity on your low pages, right, on low bot hits. So another thing actually that you can do here is take a look at, I wonder if this, yes, so sitemap URLs with no bot activity. Try to take a look at these pages. Maybe you've got some non-indexable pages in there. Maybe you're actually disallowing certain pages as well. Or if these are squeaky clean URLs, maybe they are indexable. There may be just in a sitemap that's got more than 50,000 URLs in them. As most of you will know, Google will only recognize the first 50,000. It is an issue if you have more than 50,000 URLs in a sitemap, and that could be the reason why you don't have any bot activity on these pages. It could be also as simple as adding a last modified date on the sitemap. To make sure that Google comes back and crawls these pages again, or just verifying it for any non-indexable pages, as I said, or any disallowed pages as well. And then finally, obviously, you identify indexable pages without bot hits. That's just as important as the first one, which is identifying all pages without bot hits. But here, these are really your most valuable pages, and it could be an issue of not having been able to upload a full time frame, right? Maybe you haven't been able to upload 2 weeks worth of data. Our John Myers held a webinar a few weeks ago with Eric from Stone Temple, and Eric was saying that if you can't have the 1 month worth of data, which is really ideal, then what you should at least have is a week's worth of log file data. Below a week, it's really not going to be accurate. So if you do identify indexable pages that have a bot, that don't have bot hits on them, it could just be a matter of not getting enough of a full time frame or enough of a full window to give Google the opportunity to crawl your web page, to crawl certain pages. So really do try to invest in that case in maybe upgrading your log file analyzer, so moving beyond Screaming Frog and maybe investing in Logsio. And that will give you access to more accurate data. And last, obviously, but not least, this is what DeepCrawl does very well, is it identifies orphan pages. And this is something that I've maybe spoken about in every webinar in the past, and it most certainly was brought up in the last webinar where we discussed Search Console integration. But this is just as important here. orphan pages, whether they be orphans from Search Console or backlinks. These are pages that have enough authority to be coming from these various sources, but you could spread that authority, right, across your site. So let me define orphan pages real quick for those of you who aren't familiar with them. Orphan pages are pages that have that aren't linked internally on your site, but that were found from different sources. Maybe they are old links that maybe they're old pages that have backlinks still pointing to them, and you know, maybe they could be broken, or maybe they were found by Google and indexed. You know, maybe years and years ago, you can see if you hit a site colon, you can still see some really old pages in there. Maybe Google is still indexing them and as a result still crawling them and using some of your crawl budget to reach them. And maybe you want to redirect them somewhere. But for whatever reason, they aren't linked internally on your site. And that is really something that it's a low-hanging fruit. You really could take advantage of spreading that authority across your entire site by fixing these orphan pages. So that's another use case from this log file integration. So we will be sharing some of these resources that I just mentioned earlier. So John and Eric's webinar from a few weeks ago, we'll both share it in the chat section as well as in these follow-up email afterwards. We'll also be sharing a recording of this webinar at a later date as well, if you want to go back and refresh your memory, as well as obviously the webinar from last month, which looked at the Search Console integration. Now, if there are any questions, please make sure to ask them in the chat section. I know that a few have come through during, possibly a few came through. No questions came through during, no questions came through during the webinar itself. But what you can do is you can send us an email. The team's email address is success@deepcrawl.com. You can also obviously email support if you have any technical issues uploading those logs. That's support@deepcrawl.com or from within the platform using the question mark icon in the top right-hand corner. And finally, you can always email me, Nabil, N-A-B-I-L, at deepcrawl.com. And so with that, I'd like to wish everyone a good night and good day, and I'll speak to you soon. Cheers.